By the end of this video, you will understand what is LHopital rule, when to apply LHopital rule, and when LHopital rule fails. LHopital rule is used in precalculus when solving limit functions. To understand the concept of LHopital rule, let's consider where it does not apply. Whenever direct substitution, that is, plugging, gives us a result, then LHopital rule is not important. To understand this, consider this first question. Let's find the limit of 4x plus 5 as x tends to 2. Step number 1. Wherever you see x, replace it with 2. And here, our answer is 13. And because we got an answer directly, we do not need LHopital rule. Next, consider the limit of cos x as x tends to 0. Here, putting 0 in place of x and cos 0 is 1. We got an answer, hence, we do not need LHopital rule. Next, consider the limit of sine x as x tends to 0. Here, sine 0 is 0. 0 is an answer. Hence, we do not need LHopital rule. Next, consider this question. Always remember that the first step is direct substitution, which is plugging. Hence, I will plug in 0 for the places of x, and you can see your answer is 1/2. And since we got a real number, we do not need LHopital rule. Next, when does LHopital rule apply? To understand this, let's consider this question. The limit of x squared minus 4 over x minus 2 as x tends to 2. Step number 1. Apply direct substitution. By applying direct substitution, we got an indeterminate form of 0 over 0, which is undefined. Hence, direct substitution has failed. Then, LHopital rule apply. This is the condition when we can apply LHopital rule. That is, if we encounter an indeterminate form of 0 over 0 by direct substitution or infinity over infinity, then we should apply any relevant mathematical principle or rule to simplify the function further. And if there is none, we should differentiate each variable independently without applying any method of derivatives. Afterwards, we now take the limit again. That is, we need to move to step 2. Step number 2. We are going to apply LHopital rule. And here, we got two options. Either to use difference of two squares or to use differentiation. By difference of two squares, this will take away this. And by taking the limit of the remaining, our answer is 4. We can also use another method by differentiation. Here, we are going to differentiate each variable independently without using any derivative method. Don't even think of quotient rule. It does not apply here. Differentiate this, you are going to have 2x. Next, differentiate this, you are going to have 0. Next, differentiate this, you are going to have 1. Next, differentiate this, you are going to get 0. Hence, taking the limit, you got 4. Just one method is fine. And this is what LHopital rule is all about. you can pause the video and try this out. The first step is by direct substitution. We got 0 over 0 for step 1. Next, we apply step 2, which is LHopital rule. Let's try difference of two squares. Solving carefully, your answer is 8. You can use differentiation and you still get the same answer. Next, let's consider this question. Here, we got a real number. That means I will directly substitute that for x. And by direct substitution, this is undefined. Next, step 2, we're going to apply LHopital rule. And the only method that can work here is by direct differentiation. And in step 2, I will differentiate each independently. Differentiating sine x, we are going to have cos x. Next, we are going to differentiate x squared. And we have 2x. Here, there is a minus. Next, I will differentiate 2x. And my answer is 2. By taking the limit as x tends to 0, we got minus 1 over 2. This is the concept of LHopital rule. If you're struggling with differentiation, check out the full series on calculus, both on differentiation and integration. Next, let's consider this question. Step number 1 is to plug in. And by direct substitution, we got undefined. Next, step number 2. We can apply two different methods. Because of the presence of this cube, we can apply the difference of cubes, or we can apply differentiation. Here, we can apply difference of cubes to the numerator only. Hence, everything at this top will become this. Applying difference of cubes will give you 3. Let's try step 2 again. This time around, we are going to use differentiation. Differentiate x to the power of 3, you're going to get 3x squared. Differentiate 1, you're going to get 0. Next, differentiate x, you're going to get 1. Next, differentiate 1, you're going to get 0. And here, you are now left with 3x squared. Next is you're going to take the limit of 3x squared as x tends to 1. And you're now going to have 3 multiplied by 1 squared. And you have 3 times 1. And your answer is 3, which is same as we got before. Let's consider this question. The first step is by plugging, that is direct substitution. And by direct substitution, we got undefined. Next, step number 2. Apply LHopital rule. Let's differentiate 5 sine x. And we're going to have 5 cos x. Next, let's differentiate sine 3x. And we have 3 cos 3x. Next, let's differentiate sine x. And we have cos x. Next, let's differentiate x. And we have 1. Next, we take the limit of this function as x tends to 0. And cos 0 is 1. And here, anything divided by 0 is undefined. Step number 3. We need to differentiate everything here again. Hence, we differentiate 5 cos x. And we have 5 sine x. Next, we differentiate 3 cos 3x, and we have 9 sine 3x. Next, differentiate cos x, and we have sine x. Next, differentiate 1, and we're going to have 0. Next, we now take the limit as x tends to 0, and here we got 0 over 0 again, which is undefined. Next, step number 4, we're going to differentiate this again. Differentiate 5 sine x, and we have 5 cos x. Next, differentiate 9 sine 3x, and we have 27 cos 3x. Next, we differentiate sine x, and we are going to have cos x. Next, we take the limit as x tends to 0. Next, in place of x, we are going to substitute 0. And finally, our answer is minus 22. LHopital rule also wants us to keep differentiating until we got an answer. However, LHopital rule will fail in a function that falls in a never-ending circle. For example, if you differentiate this function, you're going to get the inverse of the function, and when you differentiate it again, you are going to get back the question. This is a never-ending circle. In such a case, LHopital rule fails. Moreover, it's tending towards infinity. One common mistake is for students to leave out direct substitution and just rush into applying LHopital rule by differentiation. Differentiate this, you're going to get 1. Differentiate this, you're going to get 0. Differentiate this, you're going to get 1. Differentiate this, you're going to get 0. And you can see that you're just going to get 1 as your answer, because you avoided the first step, which is direct substitution. And by direct substitution, which is the first step, you got 1 over 2, which is correct. And by avoiding direct substitution and rushing into LHopital rule, you got 1. And here, this is wrong. Next, let's consider this question. A separate video has been dedicated to limits that tend to infinity. However, let's solve this. If you substitute infinity, you are going to get infinity over infinity. Next, you divide each variable with the highest power of x in the function, which we are going to look at in a separate video. However, here I will apply direct differentiation, where LHopital rule tells us to differentiate each variable independently. Next, I will take the limit as x tends to infinity of the new differentiated values. Substituting infinity, I got minus infinity. Next, I will differentiate again. All the x have disappeared, and we are left with minus 4 over 3, which is our answer. In subsequent videos, we are going to be looking at where the powers of x for the numerator and denominator are not equal, which has been dedicated to another video, and many more questions where LHopital rule can be applied. In the next video, we are going to start solving series of exam questions in limit functions. Make sure you check out other videos. and Precalculus. And to locate all the videos, follow the link on the screen. I will see you in the next video.